right, man. Pod Talk Sports. Week. I don't even know what week this is, but we're just doing predictions from.
Is college 2 weeks behind NFL, or are they 1 week? With Corona, it's usually, I mean, regular world, it's 1 week behind.
Facts.
But I, weeks behind, I don't know.
I don't know, but I just know we're doing predictions for the 16th of October to the 19th of October, pretty much. Yeah. You know, we're going to start off.
NFL, though. I know it's week six to NFL.
Yeah.
Week six to NFL.
Facts. So, I mean, my first pick for this week, I got Clemson covering the spread against Georgia Tech.
Okay.
And the spread is 27.
Base spreads are always high.
Facts.
Damn, four touchdowns.
Facts.
And they covered a four touchdown one. I know they covered a two touchdown one with Miami. But the previous high spreads, I don't think they covered. That's, so, I mean, I get due to cover a high spread. They seem to be in rhythm now.
They covered against Miami.
Yeah.
But they haven't covered any other ones, and they was playing scrubs, and I think that's just due to them not having to play Trevor Lawrence in the fourth quarter. So now they're playing him in the fourth quarter because you're playing a real team.
Yeah.
True. I got West Virginia. West Virginia's at home. They'll probably cover the spread against, what is it, like Eastern Kentucky or something like that. They play good at home, bro. That's the law. That's a lot. Huh?
Yeah. It should be ECU, yeah.
No, Eastern.
Eastern Kentucky?
Eastern Kentucky, not Eastern Carolina.
Okay.
ECU, nah, I'd be like, hold on, they're a little bit better opponent. Yeah.
That's a bigger.
Right. Yeah. I got Kentucky versus Tennessee over 45. I just think that Tennessee and Kentucky, they both have good offenses. Their defenses lack early game.
Over 45 ain't nothing for college.
It ain't nothing for college, bro. These teams have been bro.
They have over 45 damn near halftime.
Listen, bro. I'm going to tell you about college. The reason why these overs are hitting is because RPO schemes, defenses did not get to prepare for RPO schemes because they had no spring. So these teams that are doing RPO schemes, these safeties and these linebackers, they don't know the reads because they didn't have the time to study it. So it's like, and you got another opponent every week. So it's like, bro, you really behind the game. You're really behind the eight ball. And that's why teams are able just to, teams are looking better than what they look because no team had time to practice.
Yeah, exactly.
And COVID is making the overs hit.
Especially with college.
Yes, with college. With college, because they kids, Kevo. Hey, these ain't pros. Miami versus Pitt. I got the over on that, over 47.
Yeah, that's a lot.
That's a lot. Kevo say it's a lot. I say it's a lot. It's a lot.
Miami gonna put up some points, and Pitt always gives Miami some trouble. So I'm gonna have to assume Pitt puts up some points also.
Facts.
So that's not much. Still 40 some points. They got that.
Facts. Ole Miss versus Arkansas.
Ole Miss versus Arkansas. I mean, you kind of disagree.
Listen. Ole Miss. Listen. This spread is trap bait. It's trap bait, bro. It's 1 point. You're telling me that Ole Miss is only 1 point better than Arkansas? Cap. Now they're using history to make the spread. They're saying over time these games are close because it's kind of a rivalry. Lane Kiffin's a new coach. Felipe Franks is a new quarterback, and he's not it. And Lane Kiffin is it. They're going to run high tempo like they did against Alabama, and they're going to blow these guys out. It's just a fact. It will be more of a shootout, too, as well, though. But later in the game, two or three touchdowns, they're going to...
Ole Miss separate. I can see that. But you never know injuries, all that shit. I don't know. Yeah, I wouldn't touch it, but Ole Miss probably going to win.
Ole Miss is going to win. Shootout. But the over-under is 73, and I don't like
Jesus.
That. I don't like the 73 and the 1. Something is wrong, bro. There's no way a team is doing 73 points and it's just going to go down to a 1 point game. It don't make sense. That's a shootout. One got to win by 7. One got to win by 7, bro. You see what I'm saying? That's how I know they trapping you on the spread. Hey, biggest game of the week for college football. Alabama. Alabama and UGA. Let me tell you what's about to go down. Okay, you got one team that has a great defense. You got one team that doesn't have a good defense. Alabama don't got a good defense. But you got one team that has an offense that gets 8 to 9 yards per play.
Yes.
Every play, bro, you get 8 to 9 yards, home or away, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
High-powered offense.
So, look, this is what I put together. Georgia has to play perfect on defense for them to stay in the game. They have to play perfect, not play good. They have to play perfect because a team that has eight.
I'm not sold on Mac Jones.
Listen.
Mac Jones going to have to. Hey, we're going to see. We're going to see about you. Boy, you love Mac Jones, don't you?
Mac Jones. Mac Jones had a shootout game against LSU, which he scored enough points to win that game, and had a shootout game against Auburn, which he should have won that game. What you talking about? He went against. I'm saying you're not sold on them, but I see him go against last year. I see him.
Auburn, the Iron Bowl, like
he lost by a touchdown.
To a true freshman.
But at the end of the day, it wasn't on him. You scored enough points to win. Once you score 40-plus points, that's enough to win a game. Your defense got to stop. Your defense is allowing more than their average. What I'm saying is they got the same team that they got last year, just different wide receivers that can do the same thing. Jalen Waddle, Smith, them boys do the same thing that Ruggs and Jerry Jeudy can do. And they got a running back that can come out the backfield and catch out the backfield and hit the hole. And what I'm saying is we're not even going to talk about their offense because stat-wise, no one has stopped them. They're getting first downs every time.
It's the best defense they're going to play this year.
Exactly, but that's the thing. Okay, they're playing the best defense, but that means the best defense has to play their best game. And they've been playing scrubs. So all I'm saying is Georgia has to play their best game and play perfect defense to stop an 8 to 9 yard per play offense.
Only reason I'm a lean Alabama is because I'm just not sold on Georgia's quarterback. If Georgia had a solid quarterback, a Justin Fields or
a playmaker,
I would take him.
He's more of a game manager that can throw a lot better than Jake Fromm.
Yeah. So if they offense hot and clicking and that defense can get pressure on Mac Jones, force a couple turnovers, hey, we're going to see.
I'm going to tell you this too, though. Kirby, I'm going to tell you one thing I don't like about Kirby. And we said this early in the show. Kirby does not like to run scores up on teams. He had the option to run it up on Auburn. Why didn't you do it? Now, the reason why you should do it is because when you have to play a four-quarter game, your team is in tempo to play four quarters. You ain't never had to play four quarters. When you have to play four quarters and you ain't never done it, it's hard to ask your team to do it. Your team, your defense is a first-team defense that ain't had to really play a fourth quarter yet. So that concerns me when you're playing a ranked opponent that's higher than you. See what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
Overall, I mean, I'll say this. If you could take Georgia on a teaser, the game would be a little bit close. But at the end of the day, Alabama going to win by 4. Alabama will win by 6. You see what I'm saying? Like, they going to win by a touchdown pretty much. Like, I don't see it not happening. Nick Saban's not going to be there. He going to have them analysts and them coaches. Bro, don't make no mistakes, bro. And then I'm going to tell you, because he's not there and he's virtual.
I don't think it's going to help Bama, though.
I think
being on the sideline is big for them.
I think it is, but I think, too, it's like mom and dad not being at home for that first time. You're not going to do nothing stupid. You're not going to do nothing stupid your first time because you don't want to mess up. You see what I'm saying? Your first time your mom and dad ain't home, you're going to be good. Now, that second time you'll mess up because you know you can get away with some stuff. But at first, you're going to do what you need to do because you don't want to mess up, bro.
Yeah, that's facts.
And they're going to be able to see, he's going to be seeing the game from a different perspective. He's going to see some more stuff. It's at Alabama.
Oh.
Listen.
Yes.
And then this is two. Kirby, I'm going to say this. Kirby is going to rely heavy on that run game. And they haven't had a 100-yard rusher in no games.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? They're going to pound that ball. And I will say, their running game might look a little bit better, but that's running the clock out against a team that's going to be able to score on you. So,
or fast. Or
you feel what I'm saying? I've seen Alabama score on a third and six late in the fourth quarter this season. Like, bro, we thinking they're about to hand the ball off. They just lob it up. Touchdown, quick. It's like, don't play with them. Alabama going to win that game, though. It's just, that's the lock. Like,
I go out in Tuscaloosa, bro. Hey, I guess I go out. Sneaky. Georgia sneaky.
Yeah. Sneaky locks. Oklahoma State over Baylor over 52. I'm sorry. Oklahoma State, Baylor over 52.
Over
50. Yeah. North Carolina to win by 13. And then I got Troy. I forgot who they played, but I got Troy in there to win. They're going to blow this team out. That's facts. Okay. And then I got Navy ECU over 55. That's a lock.
Are they putting up points like that?
Putting up points. It's going to happen. Over 55 going to hit. Take it. Let's hit this NFL, Kivo.
Who you liking, man? Who you liking for the NFL, man?
These games look spooky, bro.
They're hell, bro. You got the Giants and the Redskins. Like, that's one. That's over under low. What is it, 42?
Yeah.
Oh my God! Yeah, that'd be a sneaky game where folks think they're not gonna score.
Yeah,
and both defenses might not show up. Daniel Jones might go nuts, and whoever the hell, I think Alex Smith back starting for Redskins. I think.
Yeah,
because I think boy got hurt last week. So we going it's going over 42 ain't nothing.
Hey, over 42 ain't nothing. That's a lock. I like that.
Yeah.
Now you got that Green Bay Tampa Bay game, Kivo. Talk to me.
Now that Green Bay Tampa Bay. I like Aaron Rodgers beating Tom Brady without Belichick. Tom Brady ain't got Belichick no more, bro. Belichick kept Brady in games by keeping Aaron Rodgers. Aaron Rodgers can't score. Like, Belichick is a scheme god. So, without Belichick on Brady's side, it's a shootout now. Who you taking? Who got a better arm? Who got better weapons? Who offense is better?
And I like that over.
I like Green Bay offense beating them, bro.
I like Green Bay to win. I feel keep on that. I like Green Bay to win, and I like the over for that game because at the end of the day, Green Bay is going to score 30 points, and Tom Brady is not going. He's going to do everything in his ability to try to beat him, so he's going to put up some type of points.
Tom Brady got that craziness. Like, he's going to try everything he can do to win that game,
right,
which might lift them up, him just trying to do too much.
Yeah, but it's going to result into some type of points. So. Yeah. Then you got that L.A. Rams game, man.
L.A. win. Close win, you feel me? Because San Francisco just got embarrassed last week.
Nasty game. Kivo said it. A nasty game. But go ahead, though.
Nasty little. It might be rough, just like how Dallas Giants was. Like, why is that game close? It's a division game.
Mm-hmm.
San Francisco, L.A. down to the wire. L.A. win by field goal on some crazy shit.
I like it. All right, you got New England Broncos.
New England winning.
New England Broncos, man. I like New England. If Cam ain't back, I like Jerry Stidham and I like Cam. And I know I'm Auburn biased, but
even with Cam or Jerry Stidham, Patriots are just disciplined.
They disciplined. Denver Broncos, man, they on a 7-string quarterback. They struggling. Yeah. Wide receivers are getting agitated because they want the ball. Man, defense is a little shaky. They got a few playmakers, but it's shaky.
Out. So, I'm going to take Patriots.
Hey, any teaser for this week coming from my boy Kivo, take Jets plus 17. Please, I like it. Jets might mess around and win. Underdog, if you want to throw an underdog in there, because this is going to be a week of some BS, just take Jets money line. It's a risky pick. It's not a lock. It's a risky pick, but it might just hit.
Ryan Fitzpatrick so hot and cold.
Yeah.
His ass might throw two picks in the first half and just throw up, like, the whole momentum of the game is just throw the team just off groove now. Like,
facts.
They can win that shit. It's Miami. Don't forget. It's still Miami. He ain't in there yet.
I ain't sold on him right now, because how the season's looking. He'll mess around and go in there. He might ball. He might not, though.
Yeah,
so that boy does not like pressure. I'll cover zero him all game.
Yeah, they want him in, though. They looking like, damn, Ryan Fitzpatrick doing this with them? Imagine if we had our boy in.
Yeah, they got it. But they know he injury prone. Why waste it on a season that could get canceled, too?
Exactly.
That ain't even smart. But yeah, man. That's the show, man. Take our picks, man. We did great last week. We're going to do great this week. This week is going to be a lot more tricky. It's going to be a few picks in here that we might mess up on because Vegas is just going to mess it up. But for the most part, it's some solid picks in here that you can take and win you some money. Let us know what you win. Hey, man. Hit us up for the feature. Y'all ain't hit us up for the feature, bro.
I'm trying to see what y'all like.
Come on.